MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 6 of the American League Championship Series between the Houston Astros and the New York Yankees. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, obviously, a lot of things still up in the air as we get ready for Game 6.
Yeah, you see the results through the first five games. It's been everything we could have hoped for. And now, at 3-2, you've got a team coming in here that needs to win the final two games on the road to take the series. Going to be a tall order to fill, but I think they're as capable as anyone to pulling it off.
All right, the stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in out in the bullpen, and we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Gerrit Cole will do the pitching with a trip to the World Series on the table. Dan, any thoughts?
Not many better in the game than this guy right here, Matt. Gerrit Cole, he brings the goods. Fastball approaches near 100 miles an hour, hard assortment of breaking pitches, and on top of that, he's a winner and he loves to be a big game pitcher. You'll know early if he's attacking the strike zone and has a 1-2-3 inning. Pretty good chance he's not giving up very many runs in this one.
Looked like he got fooled on the speed there, 2-2. A little chilly, but not unbearable tonight. 55 degrees here at first pitch. The 2-2. Lifted down the line and left. And foul. Another 2-2 offering. Swing and a liner. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question. Want the fans to be safe.
And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Next to hit, Alex Bregman. One out, nobody on. Hit out toward second. LeMahieu's got it. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. Next, it'll be Michael Brantley. Fly ball right down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. Curveball locks him up, strike three, and that's the third out. Astros go down 1-2-3, and now the Yankees will see what they can do. No score. Justin Verlander is charged with keeping their hopes alive on the mound here in the League Championship Series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, we're taking a look at one of the top pitchers in the game. This guy has over 200 career victories, and he'd like to add another one to this list. This guy's been a really good pitcher for a long time, and right now, he's showing no signs of slowing down. It'll be interesting to watch him work in this one here.
And this is lined into left field for their first hit of the ballgame.
Batter second, the right fielder, Aaron Judge.
So now here is Aaron Judge. Here now the 2-2. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout.
Some guys with big arms like this, they're just chuckers. They just throw the ball as hard as they can, and where it ends up isn't that big of a concern, but that wasn't the case there. That was a very well-pitched fastball right on the corner at the knees. Good luck hitting that one.
Standing in now, Aaron Hicks. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. And with two away, here's a look at our updated playoff brackets. And the question on everyone's mind is, will we be able to punch our first ticket to the World Series after tonight's ballgame? Giancarlo Stanton now. LeMahieu off of first with two away. And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's one and two.
You know, from an offensive standpoint, they already knew they had their work cut out for him against a great pitcher. But if he's going to locate like that, this is going to be a tough day.
Popped up. Gurriel waits on it, and he makes the play to end the inning. The Yanks leave one. Still no score. Astros cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Correa, left field and carrying well. Looking up is the left fielder. And that one is gone. It's a solo shot here for Carlos Correa. His second home run of the series, and the Astros take a 1-0 lead.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
At the plate now, Yordan Alvarez. Hit back up the middle. Torres scoops it up. Gone and sailed right over his head at first.
The first baseman, number 10, UDFB.
Into the box now, Yuli Gurriel. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Good job by the catcher to keep the ball from getting too far away and allowing that base runner to get into scoring position. That keeps the double play in order, which they need, seeing as they've already given up one run in this inning.
On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now. Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out.
Wow, that's the case right there where a pitcher knows this guy's up there and he's in swing mode. That pitch wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he still swung at it.
Into the box, Kyle Tucker. And a fastball that misses up in the zone here. It's 2-1.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
3-1 to him now. Runners on first with one down. And it's fouled away. Third baseline. And this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Payoff pitch one more time. misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away.
Well, when you go with the slider there in a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
Now at the plate is Miles Straw.
Everything this guy throws is hard. That changeup he throws is in the high 80s to go along with that good heater.
In the dirt here. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just starts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
In now, Jason Castro. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. 2-2, the pitch. Line drive to center field, and that's in there. Base hit, long throw to the plate, and this will not be close, and the run will score easily.
Now batter.
And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Stepping in now, Jose Altuve. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
All even now, 2-2. Tucker over at second. Castro at first, two out in the inning. Hit weakly back to the mound. On to first, and that'll do it as they manage to not let this inning get out of hand. So two runs on three hits, including the home run. No errors, and two men left stranded. On now to the bottom of the second. It's the Astros 2 and the Yankees nothing. Digging in will be Luke Voit. He's set to lead off the home half of the second.
You know, these next couple innings are really important for these guys. I know they're only down by a couple, but they need to get something going on offense to keep pace, even though it's early.
Two balls and a strike to the Yankees first baseman. Just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
That is good.
One out, base is empty, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two. Next for New York, Clint Frazier will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Ball two as the slider dips below the zone. Bases are empty here with two men out. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul.
He's one pitch away from striking out the side, but even more than that, to throw a donut up after your offense put up some runs, I can't tell you what that means to the boys in the dugout.
hard hit ball to second. There is Altuve. Oh, it sailed right over his head at first. And how about the recovery here as they get him at second base? So forget about the miscue there as the inning is over. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They trail it here 2-0. New inning set to get underway, and set to go is the third baseman, Alex Bregman. Here now the 2-2. Is in there, a called strike three.
Well, no preferential treatment there. Sometimes we see great hitters have their calls go their way on close pitches, but not this time. I think that was actually a good take, but on two strikes, anything that close can go either way.
Standing in now, Michael Brantley. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
That has to make you feel really good as a pitcher, right? Now you're making pitches all around the zone, and then you bring that one inside. You can't do anything with it. What does it do? It just locks you up inside. You have no chance to put the ball in play.
So now to the plate, Carlos Correa. Correa, left field and carrying well. Left fielder looking up, and this one is gone, a home run. A solo shot here to left, his second home run of the game, and the Astros have taken a 3-0 lead.
Well, he's obviously very comfortable in the spotlight here. In the postseason, everything is amplified. Runs mean more, and every pitch counts, especially when you make a mistake as bad as this one. Missed his location, and he takes it out of here in a heartbeat.
To the plate now, Yordan Alvarez. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two out, nobody on. And he tried to hold up that time. We'll get an appeal down to third, and no swing. It's ball three. 3-1, here it is. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Well, he walked him on five pitches, but that last pitch was really good. He missed down, but only by a hair. When a hitter has a 3-1 count, he can wait until he gets a pitch he loves.
Digging in next, Yuli Gurriel, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1.
Great game plan so far by this offense. They're not chasing any of those breaking balls out of the zone.
No dice on the knuckle curve that time. 3-1.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Alvarez, the runner at first with two gone. Can't keep that one fair, and now the count's full.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Grounder down the line at third. And he's safe at first as he beats this one out by about a half a step.
Boy, that's what wheels can do for you, Giro. You can see this right here on this replay. He just simply outruns the white rabbit. He just outruns the baseball.
Yeah, it's beautiful to watch. You know why? Because this is the one tool you can't teach. You can take countless ground balls. You can hit till your hands bleed. But if you got no wheels, newsflash, you got no wheels.
At the plate now, Kyle Tucker. And a slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
Shin-high fastball that time, ball three.
3-1 here, you have to make a good pitch on the mound. Grooving one here rarely works in your favor unless the hitter tries to do too much with it.
pitch misses for ball four. So some intrigue now as the bases are loaded here with two away.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone. So you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
Ready now is Miles Straw, one of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far. Base is juiced now with two away. And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
And it's times like these that a pitcher feels awfully lonely. I can see why he didn't want to be too aggressive. Last thing he wants to do is give up a grand slam to a dangerous hitter, but walking in a run is painful too, and here he is again still with the bases loaded.
Now to bat, Jason Castro, eighth batter of the inning now with the bases loaded and two away. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher.
A strike away now from getting out of this mess. Sometimes pitching is all about minimizing, right? So keeping it to two runs across in the inning would be huge.
Two out, bases loaded. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been as they'll strand the bases loaded. The side is retired. So they do strike for two, but it could have been much worse as they strand the bases loaded. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Astros four and the Yankees nothing. Now to the plate, Gio Urshela, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1.
We got a full
and
count.
It's up to a 3-2 full count now.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
I know one thing. He earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
Up next, Gary Sanchez. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. Brinkley is going to get back and he'll put this one away on the warning track for the first down. So the batting order turns over now and set to go DJ LeMahieu. Second at bat here. He reached via a single to lead off the home first.
Not an easy thing to do when you're in a leadoff spot, but that was a good piece of hitting in his first at bat, an opposite field base hit, which leads me to believe that this guy's going to cover both sides of the plate.
Tucker is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Number 99.
So next to bat will be Aaron Judge. The 1-1 home is strike two swinging.
He got a swing and a miss on that last pitch, but that's not the location he wants to live in against a hitter of this quality.
Got him looking, and that ends the inning. One left for the Yankees. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. And back in Phoenix as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros offense with Houston's manager, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. He cited the four walks they've earned already as evidence that his guys are waiting for the right pitch and that they're willing to let the opposition work themselves into trouble. So far, that's paying off.
All right, Heidi, thank you. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Jose Altuve.
2-1.
Well, it's been a rough one so far. 4 runs through 3 innings. It's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
And obviously, this guy's a double threat up there. He can run, and he can go yard, too. You don't want to walk him because he might steal a base on you, but you don't want to groove a fastball either because he can take you out of the yard.
Again, he sends it out of play. Still 3 balls and 2 strikes. The 8th pitch of the at-bat. And he fouls this one off. Fouled away.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
And he lays off there, ball 4. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number 4.
And that will put a smile on any manager's face. The pitch total of the opposing pitcher just keeps going higher and higher, and he still couldn't put him away. So this inning is off to a good start for the guys carrying the sticks.
Next up, Alex Bregman, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Altuve aboard here at first with nobody out. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Judge will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Here's Michael Brantley, and he's at risk of the old hat trick. 2 strikeouts on his line so far.
Yeah, it seems like these hat tricks and golden sombreros are a lot more common than they were, say, 10, 15 years ago. Guys have stopped worried about striking out as much. It's really been an ideological shift in the game that's a big topic of debate.
Yeah, guy's not going to worry about 3 strikeouts if he can add a game-winning hit to that line. Over the first, Cole, a dive, but he's back. Now the 1-1 pitch. And this one's in the dirt. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. From the stretch. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. And Hicks will settle under this one for the second out. 2 down with a runner at first. And the former number 1 overall pick and American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next.
Ah, man, he's making a lot of noise in this one. He's feeling really locked in at the plate right now. We used to have a saying in the dugout, anybody could get 2. There ain't too many guys hitting north of 2 bombs in the game in the big leagues.
From the belt, kicks and deals.
Two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And the payoff pitch. And he misses again. Ball 4. And his control is really letting him down now.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed. And now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
Alvarez.
Driving forward now is the DH, Yordan Alvarez. 2 men on, 2 away here in the 4th. Two and two.
I don't blame the batter for pulling the trigger right there. Those fastballs light up your eyes, and you can occasionally do damage with them. But he wasn't able
to. We'll have to press pause as that strike 3 to retire the side. Couple of walks in the inning, but nothing on the scoreboard. More from Game 6 after this message and a word from our local stations. ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And that'll bring in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. Three and two to the Yankees center fielder. Two pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do?
Now
he just throws this good fastball
hitter
right by. Doug brings Carmo the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Into the box, Giancarlo Stanton. Struck him out.
Boy, this guy has really good stuff so far on this one. How about seven Ks, and we're just in the middle innings of this one. If he continues this up, this could be a real solid performance.
In now, Luke Voit. Little chopper back to the mound. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They trail here 4-0. Clark Schmidt, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here.
Number 86.
Yuli Gurriel, a hit in two tries so far. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Changeup taken for ball three, well below the zone.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And they're going to have a leadoff base runner here as the fastball is lined in to left, a base hit.
3-1 fastball, middle cut, and he didn't miss it. That's the fight throughout the course of the game, to get yourself into count leverage and capitalize.
Kyle Tucker, breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball. Started to go around there. Looked like he held up in time. No, strike two, says the third base umpire. The 2-2. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. The 2-2. Fouled off. Gurriel gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Now a throw over, and he'll be back in standing up. Here's another 2-2.
Gotta believe that runner from first is gonna be in motion, especially in this situation. As an offensive player, just hit something hard because those defenders are gonna be moving.
Double play ball to second. Four. A tag for one. To Voit in time for the double play. Final line there for the Yankees starting pitcher. Clearly not the postseason outing he had envisioned.
Hey, there are a lot of things you can't control when you're on the mound, but one of the things you can control is throwing the ball over the plate into the strike zone. He didn't do a very good job in this one. Several walks led to the demise of this outing.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Here's a high pop-up. Torres has a play. And that will end the inning. Astros are down quietly, but they're in front 4-0. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the big-time power threat, Gleyber Torres. Now the 2-1 pitch.
Hey, two. I got to count 2-2.
Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
I always like watching pitchers that attack with their fastballs until there's a reason to start now mixing it up. He hasn't needed many of the secondary pitches so far in this one. And there was another good fastball for a strikeout there.
Into the box now, Clint Frazier. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. Easy take there, and it's 3-1 now. No runs, just one hit, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Mine to the right side. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. So only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, Matt, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
To the plate now, Gio Urshela. On a line to shortstop. Throw back to the bag, and the runner's back in time.
Now batting, catcher, Gary.
Next to stand in is Gary Sanchez. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Castro gathers. And the throw to first ends the inning. Yanks lead one. They're down 4-0. Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. He's set to lead us off in the sixth inning. Now the 2-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Double-barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Well, you gotta love a live young arm. He's got an electric fastball. And if he can learn to harness that and work in his solid secondary stuff, he's gonna have a really nice career on the mound. Not everyone is gifted with a fastball like that.
Standing in now, Jose Altuve. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. In there, and it's even now, 2-2.
Two,
balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. Last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count, 3-2.
Swing and a miss on the chop, and there are two gone.
Well, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with a strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
At the plate now, Alex Bregman. Into the corner and slicing foul.
Hey, with two outs in the number two hole, you're just trying to get on. You got the big boys coming up behind you.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair, like
a swing and a miss, that retires the side, and that will do it. 1-2-3 go the Astros, but they hold a 4-0 lead. Now at the plate, here is DJ LeMahieu, flew out last time up. The 1-1 is looked at for ball number two.
Hey, that's not an easy pitch to hold your swing up. I know it looked like it was way off the plate. Good job not swinging at it.
The 2-1. Ball even at 2-2. Looking for his 10th strikeout. Here's the pitch. And another foul ball. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Here's big Aaron Judge, 0-for-2 for him to this point. Here's the 1-1.
All you want is the leadoff man to get on to start a big inning, maybe get a big rally going to claw your way back into this ballgame.
Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. Altuve for one. To Gurriel, and they get them both.
Nice job on the mound to bounce back from the leadoff walk. Those are usually pretty costly, but that won't be the case this time after the two ball.
Stepping in next, Aaron Hicks. No one on base for him after the double play.
Yeah, Matt, that two ball really changed the complexion of this inning. It looked like the middle of the order was going to have a chance to get a big hit with some ducks on the pond, but now they just have to try and get a two-out rally started.
Here now the 2-2.
I got 3-2.
Tried to backdoor him and lock him up with a curveball right there. Pretty good pitch, but he didn't quite get it to come back all the way to the corner. That's tough to do for most guys.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And it's fouled away. Another full count pitch home. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Yankees. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. seventh inning ready to roll, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Now the 3-2 pitch. Full count still.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh and four.
Now batting.
Carlos Correa steps in once more as we look back at the big game he's already had. He got off to a fast start with two homers in the early going. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. LeMahieu for one, but no real shot at two as he saved easily at first. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
And he has to dive, but he's back in easily. Pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight. In now, Yuli Gurriel. And he lays off the pitch down and away, ball two. Four runs, six hits, one error so far for the Astros. High in the air out to center field. Hicks is under it. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. Astros lead one. They lead it 4-0. Digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. 1-1.
I got 2-1 the count.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Oh. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Three balls and two strikes to the Yankees DH.
Not a spot you expect a curveball. He's lucky he missed because that's the kind of pitch that gets hit out of the ballpark.
And he fouls this one off. He'll try it again, 3-2. Finally, just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
When you're this deep into a start, it can be really exhausting and annoying when a hitter makes you work as hard as he did right there. He got the strikeout, that's great, but he's probably thinking, get that guy out of here.
At the plate, Luke Voit. Fouled away. One, two. Fouled off.
I mean, this offense has struggled because they haven't been able to make the adjustment. He stayed staunch on the outer half, and these guys have not worked the ball the other way.
To two balls and two strikes now. A little late with the swing, but he stays alive. Still 2-2. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as the offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
In the air, down the line and left. Brantley is under it. And he hauls it down in the corner. And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7, 8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Two out, nobody on. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Brentley will wait on it. As he puts this one away, the side is retired. Nothing across here this half of the inning. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. Houston leads this one 4-0. Ready to begin the 8th, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Kyle Tucker. The 1-1. Waves and misses for strike number 2.
Hey, chalk that up to one you get away with. Once, maybe. Change up, belt high and above.
And just past his outstretched glove into left, the base hit.
Hey, some guys can handle the postseason lights, and this is obviously one of them. Another base hit leading off for the boys. This guy's had a monster postseason so far.
Into the box now, Miles Straw. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. So a two-run shot to left center as they pile on. It's now 6-0.
And with one swing at a bat, he shows you why he's dripping with tools. He's got the speed. He's got the power. You don't know how to attack this guy. You can't put him on base with a knock or a walk, or he'll just end up on second or third. And if you leave something over the heart of the plate, that's what can happen.
Stepping in now, Jason Castro. And that fastball's too much for him there, 1-2. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around first is Castro, heading for second now. And they'll keep it going here as he's in with a double. Wow, this is a perfect example of a Wiley veteran doing what needs to be done to deliver for his team.
Yeah, just watch this swing. Instead of trying to do too much with it and pull it, he stays inside the ball and is able to smack it to the opposite field for a double.
Kieran O'Day enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is.
56. Jared O'Day.
Into the box, Jose Altuve. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
All the makings of a big inning right here. One already left the yard, and the power hitters are coming up.
Here he comes on a ball and 2 strikes.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
Second with nobody out. Hit the other way out toward right field. Judge is under it. He makes the catch, and tagging is the runner from second. So next to hit is Alex Bregman. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
The 1-1 home is laid off for ball two.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
One, here it is. And he comes back with a gorgeous slider there for strike two.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late. You can't even put a good swing on it.
The 2-2 is looked at, and the count moves full. Michael Brantley is on deck. A man at third with one away. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Catch will be made here. Tagging is the runner from third. And he will score on the sacrifice fly.
Hey, every pitcher likes to have some runs scored for him, particularly when you're throwing as well as he is tonight, and he gets another insurance run on top of it.
So no one on now after the sac fly, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Michael Brantley. Here comes the 2-1 to Brantley. Runs already home here. Fastball is outside, and it's full now, 3-2. Carlos Correa would be next. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four. Carlos Correa now. He comes in 2-for-3 with a couple of home runs thus far on his line. A runner on first with two away. Heading out towards shallow right. Judge is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. So three runs on three hits, no errors, and a man left. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the Astros 7 and the Yankees nothing. Here comes the 1-2.
Ball two.
Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Here's the pitch on 2-2.
From 0-2 to 3-2. What a great at-bat to start this inning off. Hey, this could be a productive inning.
Ready to deliver the full count pitch. Swing and a miss got him reaching. The throw to first is in time, one down.
Now back.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here. Bases are empty, one man out. One and two now. Don't know how you lay off that one, but he did, and it's 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's working full now at 3-2.
That pitch was way down on 2-2, but give the hitter some credit there. Sometimes with two strikes, you're more apt to expand the strike zone, but he didn't and held off on that one that wasn't even close.
Liner towards second, but right to the second baseman, and that's the second out. Now into the box, Gary Sanchez struck out in his last trip to the plate. And it's fouled away.
So far, this has been a terrific outing for this guy. Throwing well, keeping his pitches to a minimum, locating his fastball.
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They need to get something cooking here. It's 7-0. Justin Wilson comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one.
Justin Wilson.
Plate now is the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
And he fouls this one off. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. Gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His third home run of this series as they've widened this lead to 8 now. Seen 4 round trippers from these guys so far. Dan Dero, what do you make of all this?
Matty D, Dero, I don't know what you think, but this is crazy. 4 round tripper of the game so far. They're missing out on the harder plate, not using the quadrants. In the hitters meeting, they focused on this stuff. They thought these guys could miss middle, and that's exactly what's happened.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Line drive to center field. Hicks is there, and he'll bring this one in.
Well, this one was squared up pretty good, but just like pitchers give up hits on well-executed pitches, batters make outs on balls they couldn't have hit much better.
Standing in now, Kyle Tucker. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. Sent on the ground out to second. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
Hey, guys, he's not known for being a singles hitter right here, but that's his second knock of the game.
And I'm sure he'll take him, but the guys on the other side of the scorecard might be thinking, we really avoided a worse fate. So now to the plate, Miles Straw. The 1-2. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Gone! It's a 2-run shot to straightaway left, his second of the game, as the blowout continues.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
The Jonathan Loaisiga comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. To the plate now, Jason Castro. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. Still only one out in the inning. Lays off, two and two now.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. This is skied out toward right. Judge is on the move, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. So the Houston lineup turns over, and to the plate, Jose Altuve, 0 for 4 with a strikeout thus far. The 3-2 pitch. Smoked on the ground up the middle, and that's in for a base hit. Finally, make him 1 for 5 now.
I know this guy isn't known for his hitting prowess, but that's a nice job right there. Getting a single on a 3-2 pitch in the middle of the zone. Grab your glove and flash some leather.
At the plate, Alex Bregman. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
The left winger, number 23, Michael Brantley.
And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. It was a walk in his last trip. This is on the ground over to first. Fielded cleanly. And Gould will take this one over to the bag, and that ends the inning. So two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. To the bottom of the ninth we go. Top of the order due up. It's the Astros 10 and the Yankees nothing.
Your attention, please.
The pitcher coming on now as we'll get a look at the side armor, Joe Smith.
Joe.
Here's the second baseman, D.J. LeMahieu, starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point, but these guys know these bats still count, at least for their own stats. You can't mill in your chances as a professional.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Hit the other way out toward right field. Tucker waits on it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. And there are the final numbers for the Astros starting pitcher. And he really delivered a fantastic postseason performance.
Hey, Matty V, you know when you've got really good stuff? You look down at that strikeout total. Double-digit strikeouts in this one. He had swing and miss stuff right from the beginning.
In now, Aaron Judge. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Fouled away. High in the air down the right field line. Down out there near the wall. He's around now, and they still haven't gotten to this thing. And he's in there at third with a one-out triple.
Well, we've been waiting for an opportunity like this since the game started. One out, and our first run is 90 feet away. The challenge now is to get him home.
Next, here is Aaron Hicks. And his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
Two balls and a strike. Set, and the 2-1 pitch fouled off. The 2-2. Judge takes his lead at third with one away. And he'll strike out here yet again. It's been a ballgame to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
Wow, he's just a lost cause in this one. That's the fourth time he struck out in this game alone, and that's not something he'll forget very quickly. That's about as bad of a day as you can have.
Into the box, Giancarlo Stanton. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed, and now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening. Last chance for the Yankees. Now a swing, and he pops him up. And this should do it. Bregman is there for it. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Well, that wasn't exactly a nail-biter, but it's always nice when you can get an offensive explosion like that and save your closer for another day. A comfortable victory.
Final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. Ten to nothing, the final shutout score in this one. The Houston Astros have evened up this series at three wins apiece. Justin Verlander takes home the win. Gerrit Cole was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Astros, 10 runs.